Hello there guys, my name is Curtis Shadowgster, born Bob Bill for Theme Park News, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update. Now today, we've got a couple of videos to upload. We've got one from Plopsland, from Walibi Belgium. Kept thinking of them between the two then. It is Walibi Belgium we've got another update for. That'll be construction on their brand new mega coaster. So we've got some construction pictures from there. There is supposed to be some news, I think, from a new Mac prototype or a new Mac concept. I saw like a teaser on their social media, and there might be something coming out today from them or in the near future, so we'll have to, you know, stay tuned for that. But for this particular update, we're going to be looking at Gardaland. Now, this is a follow-up to the video we did yesterday about Charmin and the track pieces that have been removed. Now, we do have some extra information about that as well, but the main part of it is a heavy rumour from the Italian coaster forums surrounding one of the park's dart rides. And this is surrounding the future of that dart ride and what could be happening to the building. Now, we're going to take all of this with a pinch of salt. It's just a heavy rumour at this bit. But before we get started, we're going to talk a little bit about Charmin and a little bit about that, and also then speak about the dart ride in question. And somebody commented it on one of my videos, and I've been sort of trying to piece it all together and share my thoughts on the potential replacement to this. So we're going to be talking all about that and all about my thoughts overall on both Charmin and this new attraction potentially. So before we get started, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss another YouTube video. And for now, let's get started straight away. We're getting closer and closer to 2,000 subscribers and also 500,000 views. So let's get the view count up, let's get the sub count up, and let's go. So before we kick off about the dart ride, we have to talk a little bit about Charmin. Now, according to someone who actually commented down below, someone from Gardaland or Gardaland themselves have actually contacted someone like in response to what was going on with Charmin, and apparently this is just refurbishment. They've confirmed it is just a refurbishment, kind of like Python at F-telling, which is what I was kind of guessing at, as I was like, surely they're not going to remove Charmin. It'd be interesting. I won't mind either way if it was removed or if it was staying, but I think I had an idea it was going to stay and it was just going to go through the Python treatment like F-telling did with Python. So I had an inkling that Charmin was going to stay, especially with the sort of new stuff they did to it a couple of years ago, and the VR stuff. Even though it lasted for one season, even though it didn't work, it was still new stuff. So I think Charmin will still be here for a while yet, and we confirm now it is just a refurbishment. However, somebody else commented, and there's a heavy rumour going around about a dart ride being replaced by a brand new indoor family coaster. That's the strongest rumour at this point. Indoor family coaster, also more likely to be launched as well. So now, before I go into detail about the attraction it's replacing and when it's going to potentially open, if it is going to happen, I'm going to talk about the dart ride in which is likely to go. So you're thinking, what's the dart ride in question? Well, it's on your screen right now. It is Ramses Il Risveglio, which opened in 2009. It's a dart ride. It's known as Ramses the Awakening. Now, this is formerly known as Valley of Kings. It's Gardaland's first interactive dart ride. Now, the vehicles on this are Omnimover, like the Haunted Mansion dart ride in the Disney parks. The original ride started during an expedition that takes riders through burial chambers, tombs with mummies, and a town with explorers partying. Now, this opened, like I said, in 2009. However, there's heavy rumours that that is set to be the site for potentially this replacement attraction for potentially the 2022 season. Now, here's the description officially from Gardaland's website on the Ramses dart ride. The fate of mankind depends on you. Take part in the greatest battle of all time. Armed with your courage and cunning aim, challenge the wrath of the Pharaoh. A terrible curse has been leashed upon you. Fight while there's still time. So that's the description around Ramses the Awakening. So this is the dart ride that opened back in 2009. And this is a shooting dart ride, an interactive shooting dart ride. It's the first interactive dart ride for Gardaland. And there's a heavy rumour among the Italian coaster forums that this could go. The interior could be ripped out. And for 2022, potentially, the strongest rumour is an indoor family coaster. Maybe, or more likely, to be launched as well. So, I mean, anyone from the Italian coaster forums all over based in Italy, If you want to back me up on that, comment down below if you've seen it in Italian Coaster forums. But I was told that through Italian Coaster forums, there had been this strong rumour of maybe a launched indoor family coaster in the Ramses building for 2022. Well, the strongest rumour, apparently, again, take it with a pinch of salt, is 2022. Personally, I don't think 2022, if it was going to happen, I wouldn't see it 2022, just for the fact that I think with them opening the water park, or I think they're on the verge of opening the Legoland water park next year. I think they're delaying that till next year. Again, comment down below if you know that for certain, but I think they're delaying the water park, the Legoland water park, till 2021, or very early 2021. And, you know, I think coming off of that big project that was originally for this year and now going to be next year, I think delaying that till 2021 and then going straight into an indoor family coaster with maybe a launch for 2022 in the Ramses building, it's a bit sudden, if you know what I mean. So, you know, would it happen? Will it happen? I'm not going to say it will. We're going to take it with a pinch of salt for now. But to be fair, I did see POV of Ramses the Awakening, and to be honest with you, it looked like a decent dark ride. I mean, other people could say otherwise, they've actually experienced it, but from the look of it, from pictures, from videos, it looked a decent dark ride. I think it looked alright. You know, here in the UK, we know that a lot of shooter dark rides from in the Merlin, especially in the Merlin chain, you know, Jewel at Alton Towers is one of them. Tomb Blaster at Chessington. You know, those two in particular have had issues over the past few years. We know that they've had problems in terms of effects not working and special effects and lights and, you know, all different things like that. There was one time, and I told you this, guys, in the previous video, when I rode Jewel a few years ago or a couple of years ago, and it actually stopped midway through the course with a Tesco tally announcement type thing. So those shooter dart rides, not exactly the best of states, in my opinion. And I think Chessington could do a bit better with than Tomb Blaster, I think. I think if they did a full Egyptian-themed, kind of like similar dart ride system to Gangster Grind in the ride that's opening next year at Alton Towers, I think they could do something similar with that in that Tomb Blaster building. Jules building, I mean, that could be incorporated into Gloomy Wood for like a launch coaster through the woods or something, or changed into a different dark ride, maybe go back to the haunted house and, you know, change, you know, modernize the way of a haunted house. And with this one, if it's true, then maybe an indoor family coaster wouldn't be a bad addition for Gardaland. And, you know, even though I would be sad that I never got to experience Ramses the Awakening, I think I would like the addition. I mean, you know, when someone told me the strongest rumour was an indoor family coaster more likely launched, I was like, ooh, that's giving me vibes Movie Park Germany here with their 2021 multi-dimensional coaster. But again, we have to take these things with a pinch of salt until something is confirmed by the park. So we do have to take these things, even though I was predicting stuff with Shaman yesterday with the removal, maybe a new coaster, or some chat refurbishment like Python at Efteling, whatever happened to it, you know, I was taking it with a pinch of salt and thinking, well, maybe none of this will happen, maybe it's just because it's winter season and things like that. I don't know if Italy's, I think Italy's on lockdown, I'm not too sure if Italy's on lockdown yet or not, but the park's usually quiet around the winter months. I know the park's usually closed by now, so they'll probably be resting the chats to give it less strain with the rest of the circuit, maybe. But we know it's going to be refurbished now, Shaman. We know it's going to be refurbished with some new track pieces, so especially around the rougher sections. So we know that's going to happen. The rumour about Ramses being ripped out from the inside and turned into an indoor family coaster with maybe a launch for 2022, that's a take it with a pinch of salt rumour. That's definitely a pinch of salt rumour. So I would just take this, like I said, just take it easy with this one. Wait until something's confirmed by the park. But I think if this does happen, I can't wait to see what they're going to go for in terms of the theme of it. Are they going to stick with the Ramses theme and just make it the coaster? Or are they going to go with a completely different form of Egyptian theme? Are they going to go for a different theme entirely? We don't know. But it should be interesting to see what's going to happen. It's definitely a room we could keep our eyes on, especially with strong rumours popping up of Ramses going. So we do have to keep our eyes on it, but take it with a pinch of salt, and that's exactly what I'm doing as well. But it's nice to start, you know, predicting if this is going to happen, what will happen, and how they're going to theme it, etc. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Keep staying tuned for one or two more videos yet to come. One, of course, from Walibi Belgium, and the other potentially around Mack Ride. So thank you very much, guys. My name is Coaster Child. Keep living the coastal life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome Thrilltastic day.